any neutral audience, not committed to one or the other, the way you presented it, a better proposition. If you oversell it, you're actually weakening your thing. To bring in New Zealand, Norway, I've lived for a couple of years in Europe. I was covering many of these countries. I know the conditions in these countries. I don't think you can apply those models and to say because it's succeeding in Norway, because it's succeeding in New Zealand, therefore, ipso facto, it is good for India. No. That is overstating the case and getting these people to come and fight your case, because on its own steam, the way you presented it, it's very good. Secondly, that this, when it comes about, will eliminate corruption? No. It's a better system of governance, and we hope over a period of time some good things will come. But it's not going to eliminate, and some of the propositions you made that this will be better, that is to begin with not correct. What we do want to go from here, if we generally agree this is a better system, Dr. Raj and Jerry, who I congo that support, we have to take the, we always must bring in the phasing as to how to go from point A to point B. What are the milestones that we've got to achieve? And the moment you take the first step and get the first milestone going, I think you would have improved India. If we have to go from 0 to 9, at least you would have taken it to 0 to perhaps 4. And that is, for this system to succeed, or even for the proportional representation, you want inner party democracy. The moment you have the end of the dynasty system and you have inner party democracy, most systems that are workable will automatically improve in India. Second is, I suggest that some of the bodies that are decision makers or whose voice counts much beyond what civil society what can do is, we've got to present it to the election commission and ask them what their views are, what their difficulties will be, because one of the things that the election commission straight away will say, that to begin with, before the system stabilizes, the complexity that is built in into this system at this point in time is more than what is in that. So therefore, if you start by conversation and then you lay the milestones, that all right, as Anand Trivedi, Pramod Chawla, most people have said already, that how are you going to get these people who are benefiting from the present system, who are preponderant in the parliament, and no matter what happens in the UP elections or 2014 elections, as presently we know, by and large, they will continue to be preponderant, how are they going to self-destruct? We've got to start thinking of the means as to how we undermine them or how we get them to force them to agree. Those sort of strategies you've not yet worked out. I can tell you what they are because we've been thinking along these lines, not in proportional. We'll discuss it at a separate time. And the fact is that today your greatest problem, which I hope is being addressed because it's Dr. Qureshi and NNFI have been, it was their one point agenda for the last 2 years, keeping the hardened criminals out of parliament, because I have made this point earlier, the talk I gave is the constitution being constitutionally undermined, it was given in the India International Centre, that today the state of the hardened criminals, I am not taking people against whom cases have been filed for agitation or lesser crimes, constitute more than 50% of your electoral college. They are, according to the election commissioner himself, chief election commissioner, he spoke on the 28th in the India International Centre, about 34 to 35% of your parliament now, and if you take the graph of what it was last parliament, one before that, it is going up, I won't say exponentially, but in a very serious manner, it is going up. And by this trend, by about the 2019 election, this could go to 50% if it's not rectified now. In the state legislatures, take Maharashtra for example, possibly UP, it's crossed the 50%. So the point I made and I'm making again is why this is far more important than these other issues like proportional representation, that when you have the presidential elections next year or vice president, if a cry goes out to the electoral college that we want Daku Mansingh as the president, it shall be the case. The arch criminal can be the president of India as per the state you've already reached. So these are crises that have to be addressed today, this today and tomorrow morning, as opposed to others. So I wanted to make these points that whenever you go out, please, whichever the forum, whatever the subject being discussed, these are critical issues that have to be dealt with this year today. Now, I've mentioned about proportional representation. Again, I concede it's a very good, possibly a better system, the way it is explained by Dr. Raj, and my compliments.
Thank you. Thank you, General Sehgal. Pramodji, do you want to reflect and share a few of your views? We'll try and stick to the theme of whether proportionate electoral system would work for addressing corruption and promoting good governance.
हालत इस देश की ये है कि हम कुछ भी alternate देखने के लिए तैयार हैं, क्योंकि हम लोग तो drown कर रहे हैं. मैं दिल्ली में 30 साल से रहता हूँ और मैंने ये देखा कि जब पहले इस साल के शुरू में जब मैंने एक RTI लगाई थी पूछने के लिए कि क्रिमिनल्स को कैसे हटा रहे हो, तो इलेक्शन कमीशन ने मुझे जवाब दिया कि आप आके हमारी फाइल देख लो. तो जब मैंने फाइल देखी, मैंने उनसे कहा कि मुझे ये दो चिट्ठियाँ दे दीजिए आप. तो उन्होंने कहा ये चिट्ठियाँ आपको क्यों सिग्निफिकेंट है? ऐसे ये देखिए, ये गोपाला कृष्णन ने लिखी थी प्राइम मिनिस्टर को कि अब अबू सालिम और दाऊद इब्राहिम आपके कैबिनेट में आ जाएंगे, तो आप उसका क्या करेंगे? तो हमारे प्रधानमंत्री साहब ने उसका जवाब दिया था, थैंक यू फॉर योर काइंड लेटर सो एंड सो डेटेड सो एंड सो विद काइंड रिगार्ड्स और बंद. ऐसी एक चिट्ठी मैंने उनके साथ एक्सचेंज की थी 2001 में, जब ये लीडर ऑफ ऑपोजिशन थे, हमारे प्रधानमंत्री जो अब प्रधानमंत्री हैं. तो उन्होंने लिखा था कि जो आप कह रहे हैं बिल्कुल ठीक कह रहे हैं, पर मैं कुछ नहीं कर सकता, ये पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज नहीं मानती हैं. तो क्या हम गिरते जाएंगे? तो अगर रोकना है इस सुनामी को, तो हमें ज़रूर ये प्रोपोर्शनल रिप्रेजेंटेशन सिस्टम देखना चाहिए, क्योंकि जैसे आपको आज सब सुबह स्लाइड्स में दिखाया, इट विल डेफिनेटली बी बेटर देन दी फर्स्ट पास द पोस्ट. बस यही कहना था मुझे.
Thank you, Pramodji. So we'll now open the floor for more questions. Yes, sir.
Yeah, I have a question on proportional.
You just have to hold the mic to your.
I have a question on this proportional representation. As on date, the largest party buys out the small parties like Lalu and this and that to buy.
When we have proportional representation, we have a larger number of small parties. So all that we are shifting is from the contestant bribing the voters, it will be the largest party bribing the elected representatives whose number will be larger and more valuable. So what we are shifting is corruption from the voter to the elected members.
Right.
I mean, that's an improvement, but is that what we are looking for?
That's a good question. Dr. Rajesh answer.
Good question.
I mean, in no country has that happened. Which have
India.
Proportionate electoral system.
Let's
not
talk about Norway. This is India.
India is exception.
Talk of India.
I love
in fact, this came up in the morning also. So, I mean, what would be done to kind of create some checks and balances? Because I agree with the question. This is like a transfer of power.
I have a small point, because at least today there is some socialism, because it gets distributed to larger number of poor people. Then these 500 or 600 people are the only corrupt people who will be left there to sell their vote every time there is a voting or party lies.
Right.